coming here today, and we are starting at 2:30 dot. Okay, thank you for your help and support for this. Okay, and I also want to say this is the fourth session we are doing under the risk mitigation business excellence series, and we have covered 280 plus audience across 80 companies. Okay, this was with support of Vikrant, and we have a BCI team as well here. They will come and talk to you very soon. Okay, and I request Srikant to come over and introduce our speakers, BCI.
Today on business excellence. As many of you know, this business excellence initiative at NASSCOM is about 7 or 8 months old. We started this initiative in collaboration with BCI. We had this initiative running a few years ago in a different avatar. It was called the Quality Initiative at that time. And then about 8 months back, we wanted to rechristen it, and that's how it became Business Excellence. And we thought that given the dynamics of the market today, the dynamics of business today, it's important to have excellence in whatever you do and everything you do to be more competitive in the global scenario, and that's how we are where we are today. We started off this initiative in Vishakhapatnam with one session on BCM, and then wanted to do certain more deep dive sessions in the larger markets, in the larger geos, such as in Hyderabad, and that's where we started the risk mitigation series, which Praveen just explained, and is the third in the line, and we have some more to go. And overall, the business excellence initiative is divided into multiple pillars, where we want to talk about, of course, risk mitigation. We want going forward, we will also get into things like software standards, benchmarking across the product life cycle, look at how operational risk can be managed, operational excellence, and things like that. And these are the sessions that you can look forward to in the days to come. And from a initiative standpoint, we have done this first only in this geography of Hyderabad, but you will be happy to know that we will take this forward nationally. We will roll this out in all the other geographies of NASSCOM across the country soon, starting April this year. There are four large pillars on which this initiative works. The first and foremost is, of course, in what we are currently in, which is the thematic-based events, workshop sessions. The second, of course, would be something that we are looking forward to work on. I think we have some very detailed discussions next week, but we want to look at how we can upscale the entire skill quotient in this particular area, because as the demand goes up, it's extremely important to have the right skills available for the industry to pick them up, and that's why we are working backwards to see how skills can be improved in this area. The third area that we would want to work is, of course, on research. We want to kind of bank on the collaboration, the thought leadership, the knowledge partnership that we have with BCI, and see what they have done across the world, and see how we can replicate this in the Indian market and make it more India-centric, and see how each and every one of us can benefit from this relationship and have more research to see what we're doing, how we're doing, and are we in the right direction. And the last but not the least, the fourth pillar that we want to talk about, which we would handle in this vertical, would be more on industry preparedness, how we as organizations are ready for contingencies, for exigencies. So this is what the Business Excellence Initiative is all about. And I would once again kind of welcome all of you to this session. And thank you very much for taking your time to be here. And I would now go on to the next part of the program. I would request Vikrant to come and do the context setting for the day. He would kind of give us a quick brief on what to expect for the day, what is going to happen, what is planned for the day. And before that, I would quick introduction to Vikrant. Vikrant is currently the chairman of BCI Hyderabad Forum and also the chief of the advisory board of risk resources. Vikrant enjoys a very long-standing and highly regarded leadership reputation in the field of enterprise risk, concentration risk management, security and fraud risk, business continuity, and so on. He's also led the foundation of Business Continuity Institute, BCI, in India way back from 2004, and is now currently supporting as the chairman of the Hyderabad chapter. He has worked with multiple large organizations, including HSBC, Fidelity, GE Capital, Tata Steel, and EXL. And he's got some excellent reputation to his credit, which says that he's the only person from Asia since the last 15 years of its inception to have been felicitated the coveted award of BCM's Industry Personality of the Year in the year 2007. Congrats, Vikrant. And he is also the first business continuity professional in India to achieve global certification with both DRI, USA, and the statutory membership of BCI. With that, over to you, Vikrant. Do give us a feel of what to expect today. Thank you.
I'll just see if I can take this and We are here for a thought leadership session, and I just wanted to start with our Bear with me for a minute. I think by the time they come up and bring the slide, I wanted to highlight the whole purpose of driving these thought leadership session, and I wanted to give a flavor of what does BCI do and how it does. So there is obviously a BCI international body which focuses on developing the framework in the business continuity space, training, good practice guideline as they call it, as well as working on the framework for training and membership development and professional development. Here in India, which is the chapter, the focus is on building community, working with like-minded organization, NASSCOM, ISACAs, CIIs, and try and see if we can create the knowledge base here and see if that could be used with the industry. The four pillar, which we highlighted and Shrikant also covered, part of the events. We are here for the event. So the risk mitigation series, we are working with NASSCOM. We are trying to see if we can similarly reach out to other industries in the conventional domain also. We also have our forum meets very regularly where the professionals work in the segment. Shrikant touched upon the research. There is a special focus group which is created as part of Think Tank, and we're looking forward to futuristic research. We are also trying to see if the Indian market need very customized report, and NASSCOM is defining the needs, and you will see some of those research in future. Skill building, we are trying to have role definitions, job family building, and correlate it with the career which can be created in this domain. There's a lot of work which is going on with MBA institutes, engineering institutes, as well as with CEO organization. So you will see some work in that space in future. And in terms of preparedness, working with various bodies, NDMA, National Disaster Management Institute, Secretary of State Governments, as well as with bodies like Cyberabad Security Council, if some of you would know, towards better preparedness for the city. The other slide. This is the fourth session. I just wanted to run you through a few slides, if it supports me. About what we covered in the previous one, and just try to give you a correlation of what we are trying to achieve in this session. So we started with the, in the previous one where we said everybody is a vendor organization, right? So we are either a vendor of somebody, or we have vendors who are supporting us. Some people like to call it strategic partner, some people like to call it supplier, some calls vendor. There are various words, and there are meanings also differently, but at least for the purpose of larger context, let's assume it all means the same. And obviously there is a huge dependency on vendors these days in terms of how we are doing. The risk is also changing now with the importance of things overall. Sorry, I think the PDF conversion of the slide hasn't gone very well. My apologies for it. The need for oversight is also changing. This slide highlights that, look at the big names. You would either be a vendor or you would be, acquiring vendor in a large space. And whenever you have organization, whether you're managing yourself or you've given the work, obviously there are dependencies, disasters, various kinds of risk which is happening, which is impacting. And our focus needs to be, how are we managing those risks? How are we ensuring that there is sufficient preparedness? In our organization, we obviously focus and have a good program, but when we correlate with the supplier or with vendor, how closely we are interconnected, that's a portion which we covered in the previous session as well. There is obviously a different emergence of terrorism across the world. A lot of us have to closely watch what is happening in the security space, and it has a huge bearing because organizations have become global. The impact has also become global, and hence we need to keep a close watch. A lot of these pictures would look familiar to you. They are penetrating in our houses, in our cities also. A lot of, you know, things. So obviously in the first session we covered, our huge focus was around disaster recovery, business continuity, and concentration risk. Then we moved our focus on overall vendor risk management program, where we were trying to see who's managing the risk for third party, how are we managing it, what's the program, how are we identifying those risks with the vendor, who's controlling that risk from the organization side, how's the relationship being managed. How are we classifying the risk? So that, you know, there was a huge discussion in the last session about risk classification. So the second session focused on overall vendor risk management and the compliance which we're expecting vendor to comply. In that, there was obviously a bit of field which we touched upon, which was in the regulatory expectation space. We talked about various expectations on the vendor as well as on the principal employer or the client on having the regulatory compliance portion. And in this session, you will see a lot of those things, you know, coming. This discussion is about how governance, risk, and compliance would evolve and take shape. So what we tried to do is, in this panel, we thought we will have consulting firms, which will give you a background of how risk, compliance, and governance space is evolving. We also thought it would be a good idea for us to have, you know, service providers, tool providers, platform providers, and talk about how industry is shaping up. We've got people from user company also. So we've got, you know, an international bank and a domestic bank, and they would share their experiences and expectation. We've also tried to have, obviously, a holistic perspective where sessions are moderated also by people who are in those roles, right? So look forward to have session in the governance risk and compliance space. As Shrikant highlighted, our next session would focus on cyber risk also. As you can see, we are evolving. So the next session is on cyber risk. And with that, I would pass on to Shrikant for introducing Avik. The next session obviously would be in July. We will talk about it more. And that would be thematic, focusing purely on cyber risk side and privacy. But look forward for having a very engaging discussion. The whole purpose is create sufficient awareness in these events, call experts from the industry as well as on the user side, and if there are sufficient, you know, opportunity for you to interact and network with people. If you have feedback, obviously we'll have time to talk after the event as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Vikrant. So the next would be, of course, the keynote address for the day. We have Mr. Avik Mukherjee, Executive Vice